作ったね。
ゴロちゃん。
おじさん。
何を聞きたい？
いや、あの見た感想っていうか、
僕は自分の子供を見てたよ。
自分の子供、
大人になってない。
Studio Ghibli is held as one of the best animation studios ever founded, with some of the most critically acclaimed and beloved films ever made. It's no secret the impact it has had on animation and film in general. Perhaps there's no one more infamous than the grand director himself, Hayao Miyazaki. Hayao, much like the studio he co-founded in 1985, is held as one of the greatest animation directors of our time. He's directed films such as Spirited Away, which many regard as one of the most beautifully crafted and important films to have ever been made. He's also directed Princess Mononoke, a delightfully crafted piece of animation with a more grounded approach to characters. Hayao is a master at storytelling with animation, carefully crafting each story into a heartfelt piece of media. Despite all this, however, lies a conflict you wouldn't expect from such a grand storyteller. A conflict, perhaps far too familiar to many others. Goro Miyazaki was born on January 21st, 1967. Since he was born, Hayao was very absent from his life. Goro, much like us, saw his own father's film in an attempt to understand a man he never knew. It's tough growing up with one of the greatest directors as your father, and this legacy left a burning impact on young Goro. During high school, Goro often felt like he would never be able to live up to that legacy. You know, the legacy that shaped so many of our childhoods is the one that terrified his own. You know, this legacy led Goro to not pursue animation, but instead as a landscaper, before eventually following in his father's footsteps. In 2005, Ghibli began production of their next adaptation, Ursula K. Le Guin's Earthsea. Goro was head of the Ghibli Museum at the time, and Suzuki Toshi, a veteran producer at Ghibli, thought to bring in Goro as a consultant for the film. Soon after seeing young Goro's storyboards, decided he should direct the movie, as he was looking for a younger and newer director to helm the studio and thought he was the perfect fit. This news almost brought immediate contention with his father, who was not very pleased to hear the news.
やめた方がいいんです、本当は。向いてない。やりたいのとやれるのと違う。
Goro himself was puzzled as well. I mean, he really had no intention of directing the film, only seeing the process for which his father has gone through. With this new massive weight on his shoulders, the stress would only begin to pile on. Goro swiftly began work on the feature film, wasting no time. During the production of Tales from Earthsea, Hayao and Goro never spoke to one another.
<laughs>
perhaps in vain, or just the will to prove his father wrong, Goro stayed working on the production. During the production, Goro kept a blog in which many of his thoughts prevailed. One specifically about pleasing not just his father, but the original author of Earthsea, Ursula K. Le Guin. He wrote, "How do I go about turning the important parts of the original Earthsea works into images? That is the problem that has been in my head all the time, from the moment I started making this movie until now." Goro, in order to remain transparent with himself, began this blog in hopes of getting people to recognize his reasoning for the decision he made. Even more abruptly, he wants to make it clear he himself is different from his father. He said, "Producer Suzuki came out with was that obviously I should let the work itself speak for me. But in order to showcase the work itself, you still need to let them know you, not as Miyazaki Hayao's son, but as the individual human being, Goro Miyazaki." Goro mainly agreed to direct based directly on his love of the books and of animation. Growing up with the shadow of a man like Hayao can lead you to be a bit scared to follow up in his shoes. Hayao himself is a bit of an open thinker. His animation and filmmaking processes are very different from conventional methods. His process begins with a simple picture, unlike most productions that start with a screenplay. Hayao opts out, instead often finding derivative, mundane things to find creative input from. That's what sets him apart from many directors, even his own son. Perhaps what strains them isn't just the way in which they perceive art, but the way they think. Hayao works in a cloud of doubt and anxiety. He shrouds himself constantly with the strain of creation. He sees his work as inferior to many others, and often has much trouble during the creative process. Hayao often says to himself during the filmmaking process that, like it or not, a film is a reflection of its director. Earthsea certainly became a reflection of Goro's relationship with his father. He incorporated elements from his own father's manga, The Journey of Shuna. It's clear the inspiration for this film came from a desire to prove himself apart from his father. Perhaps that resentment is all Goro knew when making his first feature. Tales from Earthsea was released in Japan on July 29th, 2006, to mixed critical reception. While the film itself was a financial success, earning $7.7 million in the box office, there's many strong opinions on the film. The greatest detractor is the book's author herself, Ursula K. Le Guin, who said of the film, quote, "It's not my book, it's your movie. It is a good movie." Later expanding on her opinions, stating that the film had an entirely different plot. It soon became the lowest rated Ghibli movie at that time, earning 40% on Rotten Tomatoes. The reception of the film affected no one more than Goro, who for a first time director, had an enormously impossible role to fill in the studio. After the first viewing of the film, however, Goro received a letter from his father, who simply stated, "It was made honestly, so it was good." These single few words brought Goro to tears. Even such a simple sentence meant more to Goro than any critic could write. Until this point, Goro and his father almost never spoke. Goro recalled that quote, "From the time I became aware of things up to the present, we had almost never talked." Hayao saw his son as a naive man taking up a position he wasn't ready for. While Goro saw it as his only chance to truly connect with his father, this short exchange, while minimal, left Goro with a new resolve. Goro stated on his blog, quote, "Actually, until just a little while ago, I found the idea of going on a campaign painful. Now I find the idea of going all over the place and talking to lots of people has become something I'm looking forward to. I guess I'm self-interested."
やんなきゃもう前に後ろにも進めないだろうって。もうやめれないっていうか。
Goro was a boy so scared of his legacy, he didn't even attempt to achieve it, till eventually the helm was given to him. And with no choice, began to work at carving his own path apart from his father. Even after his first film was criticized and compared constantly to his father, Goro saw the note from his father as a sign of acknowledgement. Whether big or small, it was all Goro wanted from his father. Just a sign that he was there. Goro later went on to direct from Up on the Poppy Hill, which was critically acclaimed. It was renowned for not only its themes of change and culture, but for its amazing art direction and stunning characters. It became a staple in Goro's career, who to this day directs films at Studio Ghibli. Ayo himself went on to create Ponyo, a film heavily inspired by his own family, in which Goro also worked as an animator. It itself almost worked as an apology to Goro for never being there for
him.
別にね、しょっちゅうキャッチボールやるぞとかさ、あとかやるぞとかってどっか連れてってあげようとかさ、しょっちゅう 言ってくれなくたって別にいいです。いてくれたらいいのにっていう。
Films are complicated pieces of art. Even more complicated is the process of creating them. This was the life Hayao knew more than anyone else in the world. He was a man who dedicated every part of himself to it. Hayao knew his life would suffer, but he devoted himself to his talents, leaving young Goro without his father. Goro perhaps put it best. He gets 0 marks as a father, but full marks as a director of animated films. Studio Ghibli has created the best stories of all time, truly captivating viewers for generations. But the story behind those films is just as interesting. Realizing the art in those films is within everyday life, and for Goro, the art was within his own blood. Hayao and Goro's relationship is strained and complicated, and perhaps not as colorful as Howl's Moving Castle or Spirited Away. It is, however, an important story to tell because of how real it is. Hayao and Goro were not perfect people, but through these films, we see how they truly feel about each other. Reflected through them, we see the relationship these two have and just how important each of them truly are to each other. That's what makes these films masterpieces of art. That's what makes them beautiful.
どうもお疲れ様でした。恥ずかしいんですけど。